Gonna use this belt. What's going on, guys? Coming back with another video. If you don't already know, my name is Tim. So this is episode 3 of Road to Recovery. And I just got back from PT a little bit ago. So they gave me some more exercises to do, and I kind of have to figure out how to do them here. So I'll kind of go through the other exercise routine and also film the new exercises so you guys get to see that. One thing I'll add too is I am finally off all the like pain medication. And now I'm just taking Tylenol. So, and I'm off my antibiotic too. So, I mean, honestly, the pain never really was that bad. I think that nerve block helps me a lot that I got originally. And then it's just been getting better and better from here. And I don't really have that much pain anymore. It definitely gets more sore at some points and like sometimes more sore after I do these exercises and stuff. But the exercises really helped me to like stretch out and get a lot more of my mobility. Which I've honestly, it's come a long way for the mobility and it's getting a lot better and they're saying it's progressing really well. So yeah, so far so good. Riggs is gonna help me out today too. Right, Riggs? Right. Gonna start by taking the brace off and we'll get right into it. I also didn't mention it in the last video. Happy birthday to my mom. Happy birthday. And thank you so much for helping me out. And also thank you so much to my dad for helping me out so much. Both been a huge help. Dad's driving me to PT. Both my parents are taking very good care of me. So thank you guys very much. First thing I'm gonna start with is the ankle pumps. Got 30 of these. Then I have these knee bends where I kind of force the knee to bend a little bit with my other leg and push it back up. And do this 10 times. At PT today, they did say I can get my knee to about 85 degrees, so almost to 90. Obviously, the other knee can go past 90, but it's progress. I think a lot of it has to do with just like the swelling that's on my knee that doesn't let me bend it more, but we're getting there, we're getting there. All right, so the next bending exercise I'm gonna do, take this belt and slowly pull it back to bend my knee, drag my heel across. Keep going back like that. I did that 10 times. This one can be tricky. Alright, so I'm lying down now. The next exercise is just kind of get my hamstrings firing a little bit. So, what I gotta do is lift my leg up a little bit. And then just dig my heel into the ground. Look at that hoverboard. Throwback to 2014. Dig my heel into the ground. Tighten my hamstring. Also, this is my stuffed animal gorilla. Passionately known as Pubs for all the real ones out there. He says,
hello.
So the next exercise is a straightening exercise where I have to lie down with my legs off the end of an edge and let my legs straighten and let them hang there. It's supposed to look like this. So I don't really know the best place to do this and I might try and do it on this table. So you're gonna see the process of that. This might go horribly wrong, but you know, how much worse can it get? And I have to hold it for 10 minutes. Just like this, gotta hold it for 10 minutes. So I had to hold that for 10 minutes. Really straightens out my knee, and it really stretches out my hamstring really well, which gets really, really tight during this whole thing. But I can definitely tell my knee's more sore after doing PT earlier today. Like it just feels more sore going through these exercises, but we're getting there. If you've made it this far in the video, comment your favorite type of hot sauce. As you can see, now we've made it back to the floor. Gonna do a hamstring stretch now, just like this. Put one knee up, leave it straight on the ground, and I'll lean forward, stretch this out for a few minutes. Seems like the biggest thing to keep saying is trying to keep my knee straight, because that's the problem that most people have with after ACL surgery, is the straightening of your knee. That's what it seems like, because they always want me to keep it straight. So they even said I can start taking my brace off when I'm just sitting around doing nothing, as long as I keep it perfectly straight. So I'll probably start doing that a little bit too. And I'm kind of liking filming these exercises, because it kind of, you know, keeps me accountable and making sure I do them. And it gives me a little bit of content, something to film and something to practice filming. So I kind of like it. So the next thing we're going to do is they want me to just kind of like move my kneecap back and forth and up and down a little bit, because they said a lot of times people somehow get their kneecaps kind of like stuck and it loses movement after being so stiff for so long. So I gotta do this for a while. Next thing again, I'm gonna use this belt.
Oh my god!
And then do the calf stretch. Next up is another hamstring stretch where I prop my heel up. I use this thingy, this like half football thing. I don't know why I have this, but it works perfect for this, to prop my heel up and then let my hamstring have gravity pull it down and stretch my hamstring. So I'll show you that too. Looks just like this. Gotta hold it for about 5 to 10 minutes is what the sheet says. Also, hi again, pups.
Hello.
All right, coming down to our last two exercises. We got quad sets, which is just flexing this quad, which is, this is all I can do. Keep in mind, without swelling, this would normally look like this. Instead, this is all I got. See a little bit from this side. But pretty pathetic. My quad is shot, it's all swollen. This is all I got. With the added exercises, this whole process takes even longer, but you know, got nothing else going on, so this is the best I got. And lastly, we have everyone's favorite, the flex the quad and leg raises. I still have a delay. A lot of times when I try and lift it the first time, it doesn't really go very well, but it's getting better and getting easier. Just like that. Done with the exercises and time to put the brace back on. This can be challenging sometimes. One side effect from this whole thing that I've definitely felt is just from like picking up my leg and not really being able to like bend it very well and straighten it very well. Like, you use a lot of other muscles to kind of move your kind of like dead weight around, and it's definitely caused my hip, like my hip flexor, to get sore, which isn't a big deal, but it's definitely something I've noticed, and I don't know, thought I'd share it. But now that this thing is getting stronger a little bit and I can use the muscles that are supposed to be used to move my leg, it's started to die down a little bit. It doesn't get as tired, and I don't notice it as much, so that's a good feeling. All right, guys, welcome to Tim's kitchen. Gonna make some protein ice cream. First thing I wanna start off with, about this much ice. I'm gonna put in a Fairlife protein shake to start. And we're gonna add in a serving of PB Fit peanut butter powder. And also two servings of Hershey's cocoa powder. One serving of xanthan gum. And 2 zero-calorie stevias.
Nom, nom, nom.
So my friends were over and they were gonna go get frozen yogurt and I decided to make this. I'm not gonna sit here and tell you it's as good as the real thing, but it definitely helps curb that craving and you get to stay on your calories. So I'm gonna eat this and completely stay on track. But I think that's gonna be it for the video. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and I hope you guys enjoyed that recipe. Try it out and let me know what you think. But I'm gonna be signing off. Please like, comment, subscribe. See you next time. Happy hunting.
Goodbye.